Hi everyone, welcome to LSE's YouTube channel. My name is April and I'm currently a master's student studying environmental policy and regulation here at LSE. If you've clicked on this video, you're probably wondering what, you know, social scene's like here at LSE as postgrad students. And I think this is a topic that is relevant for pretty much anyone, no matter how outgoing or social or in between you are. I've sat down with some of my friends and we've discussed our experiences and hopefully some advice we have for you. The most important takeaway, you'll hear this from everyone that I've interviewed. Everyone is feeling the same way, everyone's in the same boat, and you're not alone for feeling nervous about making friends or even feeling lonely at times. And there are so many opportunities, informal or formal, to make friends. I hope you find this helpful. And if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to leave them below.
I'm in environmental policy and regulation along with April, Lauren, and Simon.
Yeah, I'm Simon. I'm also in that program. I was trying to say.
My name's Jenna. I'm also from Canada.
I'm Lauren, I'm from the UK.
And I'm Simon, and I'm from Germany.
So I was actually a bit worried when I first met everyone because I felt that a lot of people had met before I'd met them. I was completely wrong because everyone was super friendly and especially doing stuff outside of the course, you almost just have to jump in at the beginning.
Yeah.
And it's a bit scary, but also after a week or 2 weeks, you've forgotten what that feeling's like completely.
Yeah.
Where I first kind of started meeting people in LSE, I also would have stuff going on outside as well. So I was still playing sport with my old team. I was almost worried that I'd miss out. I kind of had FOMO. But you don't have to go to everything that everyone does. It's just making sure that you put in the time to get to know people.
Yeah, I had the same feeling because I had my friendship group from my undergrad, which was also here in London. It was always okay because there was a lot of other things that were going on and people were active on the group chat and proposing new events stuff to do.
And you just kind of have to dive in, don't you?
Yeah, absolutely.
It's when you do your undergrad and you go to Freshers Week and it's almost that invitation to literally say hello to anyone.
Yeah.
And with postgrad, I didn't necessarily I knew that I could go and say hello to everyone, but I was why am I getting nervous? I've done this all before.
Yeah.
And I felt I was 18 again.
Anna and Lauren were in the same group. And I feel I didn't actually get to know you on this level until we were working on a project together for a class. And so I feel it comes in different stages. You don't have to be friends with everyone during the first week of school.
Yeah. Do it at your own pace because those people aren't going to go anywhere.
Yeah.
And if you're going to become friends, then you can do it in the way that you want to do it.
Plus there's different places you can find new friends. So there's the course and there's the accommodation if you're on accommodation. There's the societies and sport.
When I went to undergrad, I went with a ton of people that I already knew. So coming here, I genuinely did not know a single human being in this city. And it was definitely really overwhelming. I think people are all in a really similar boat. I think it kind of unites everybody in a way, because we're all uncomfortable. I think we're all more open and receptive to wanting to do things together. I think that's what's so great about LSE. I think in undergrad, when you've got people in second year or third year above you, there's a bit more of this linear continuity that you can people in the program, or you might recognize them if I'm in first year and I meet a second year, I'll see them again in third year. Whereas now I think, you kind of come in and it's just this sea of people that you've never seen before. And there's no one above you or anything. It's just this is it. So
one of the guys, Brandon, he hadn't met anyone and he literally moved here.
Yeah.
He didn't know anyone. And he just put in the group chat, does anyone want to go for dinner? And 20 of us came.
That was so great.
It was so good. Yeah. You don't, if you haven't reached out to anyone, but you're in some kind of forum or group chat, then you can literally just put a message on there and let the people come to you.
I did feel that there is more of a focus towards undergrads within the societies, and I think for prospective master's students, week zero, all this orientation stuff seems very geared towards undergrads, but that shouldn't dissuade you from joining things or don't worry, essentially.
When you know what course you're on, I remember that I was checking the Facebook page to see ways to get in touch with people, and there was a post about the WhatsApp group, and I feel that WhatsApp group then just opened the door to everyone.
Yeah.
So I'd advise just checking on whether it be social media or.
I think it's more important for postgrads than for undergrads because our programs tend to be smaller, so then tends to be more activity in these group chats.
And
then
one final personal anecdote I'd like to share. I was talking to my friend at home and in Vancouver, and I was it was literally a Saturday night, and I was I'm so tired, I don't want to go out, I don't know anyone, I have no one to go hang out with. And my friend was you know someone, I guarantee you know someone, text them and ask what they're doing. Okay, so then I messaged April and I was hi, April. And she was like, we're preying for the postgrad party. And I was like, I don't have a ticket, but I'll come pre. And then, I don't know, like from there, it's just turned into like, I guess a friendship. Like, like sometimes you do have to put yourself out there. Like it's not just going to come to you.
Like it might be scary, but that one step is worth it. Like in
the end, you're looking for that step too, right? Other people are looking for other people to take that step. So you might as well.
Well, my name's Nicholas. I'm from Benin, Burkina Faso in the US, and I'm studying international migration and public policy.
I'm Delphine. I'm also in international migration and public policy, and I'm from France, but I grew up in Germany.
How do we meet each other?
Basically, I put a message in the group chat for the whole hall. Does anyone want to go eat? And people came.
Yeah.
And April was one of them. Yeah, yeah. And then ever since we got along, we became friends.
Yeah. We're flatmates, so yeah, we bumped into each other when I was moving. My parents were there as well. Yeah, and then we found out we were in the same program, so that was a really nice surprise. And then we met. First night I actually like stayed here. Mm-hmm. There was like a pre going on in the common room. And then we went out, and that was really chill. And then you texted me the next day to go thrift shopping, or to go to Camden Market. That was really nice.
Piece of advice I'd give any prospective LSE student would be to just go to all the events, because there's always like parties and stuff going on, right?
Yeah,
so true. Even if you're not like a person, just go to a few, and then you'll meet people there.
Yeah, we went to like a post-grad party that was organized by the student union, I think.
It was like prom, but it was really fun.
Yeah. And it was held at three tons, which has really cheap drinks. It was a good night.
A lot of them weren't even organized like by the school, right? A lot of it was just like organically within the halls or the people you meet in your program.
Like our program, we organized like before welcome week, we went to Primrose Hill. That was really fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was nicer to meet outside of like the formal setting of like the reception with the prof and stuff.
And Lillian knows every night there was something going on in the common room, and also even if you didn't know the people that well, like
you could just go with
like everyone would just become friends.
I think the world was just reception. Everyone was becoming friends.
There was like a pizza night.
Oh yeah,
we got free pizza.
Exactly. And then people will be doing stuff, right? So sometimes people will be like, I want to go to McDonald's. Does anyone want to come?
Yeah.
And people will be like, yeah.
It really helps is we have a chat for the entire residence and our programs and everything.
Yeah.
So people are always putting ideas out.
Yeah.
One big thing I would say, like, I think it's in the Facebook groups that they give you links to when you get accepted. Mm-hmm. Keep an eye out on it, because like they'll create WhatsApp groups for students, like for accommodation, for programs, and that's the best way to meet people.
Yeah. I'm nervous about making friends at all, or?
I mean, of course, you know, there's always that like fear in the back of your head that you might not get along with the people.
Yeah.
I know LSE has a reputation for being, you know, a bit asocial.
Yeah, I don't get that to be honest. Yeah, a big thing, part of that like narrative, like, it's really antisocial because there's a lot of international students. And people think that they click together. I don't think that's true. Like, I think
people, they're more open to meeting with anyone rather than clicking.
And also, it's so cool to like meet people that have like different life experience than you, and that there's so much to learn.
No, compared to my previous uni, I think it's a lot more community oriented, because my previous uni was a lot bigger, so it just felt a little overwhelming. Here, like, I don't know, people are a lot more inclusive when it comes to making plans. They just put in like the group chats. So.
The school, like, there aren't too many students, the campus is kind of small, so you'll always be seeing people when you're walking around, or even walking to school.
Yeah, that's true. I also have to say, like in our program at least, the seminars are where I have my closest friends in the end. Because those are the people I see weekly, and we always grab lunch afterwards and stuff.
Also, seminars, like, I don't know about your program, but for mine, we had debates as like a
group
thing. And then we had a group presentation. And so I feel like there's a lot of opportunities to meet people in like an academic setting too.
Mm-hmm. You meet so many people that at the end of the day, it's more like finding time to hang out with all the people you met and like maintaining that connection that you first made.
I mean, I think like the biggest thing is to just like let people know that like if you have a fear of not being able to make friends, just like if you just put yourself out there even a tiny bit, you'll get way more in return and then after the rest. Don't be like embarrassed. I know sometimes people are like, oh, I don't want to like message people. But like just like push past that, or try push past that fear, at least initially.
Yeah.
Then after.
Yeah. Everyone's in the same boat.
Yeah. Exactly.